10 years after the deadly shootings at Columbine, a new move at California's Capitol to crack down, not on guns, but on bullets. KCRA 3's political reporter Kevin Riggs joins us now live with the details on this gun control measure.
That's right, Edie. Gun control groups are taking aim at bullets by tracking who buys ammunition. Gun owners say this idea is a misfire. Store owner John Barrett is not happy about a proposal to crack down on ammunition sales by requiring him to record who buys his bullets.
When the regulatory agencies come in here, it's just something else for them to find a reason to try to put us out of business.
In solidarity for the victims of gun violence at Columbine.
At the Capitol, a moment of silence for those killed 10 years ago at Columbine, as Capitol Democrats explain their push to restrict access to ammunition.
It is much easier in California to purchase handgun ammunition than it is a package of cigarettes or allergy medicine or spray paint.
De Leon acknowledges his bill would not prevent the sale of bullets to criminals, but it would require stores to keep a log of buyers along with a thumbprint.
Those logs stay on the premises of the vendor, I believe it's for 5 years, but are available to law enforcement.
This proposed law is based in part on an ordinance in the city of Sacramento. The city's had that law on the books for about a year and a half now.
What we're missing is the ability to do this statewide.
Sacramento's police chief says the law has been an effective tool, enabling arrests by matching sales records with lists of known felons.
Because we target the high-end offenders, the gangsters, and those folks who are prone to violence, it's really taken some really bad guys off the street before they're able to commit another crime.
But gun rights advocates are skeptical.
We live in a free country, and freedom goes to very, very little issues. Why should we have to put down our driver's license, put it on a thumbprint?
Ann Peretta says a similar ammo tracking program was tried nationally from 1968 to 1986 and was eventually canceled by Congress for lack of results. This measure goes before the Assembly Public Safety Committee tomorrow. Gulston.